Hello everyone, how's it going? This is going to be a quick video talking about an upcoming little game called Blasphemous. If you enjoy the video, smash like, smash subscribe, because it really helps me keep me motivated to making these videos. So without any further delay, let's get to it. For people that don't know what Blasphemous is, it's an upcoming metroidvania platformer game set in a fantasy medieval setting with religion as a heavy focus, created by the studio The Game Kitchen. It's really similar to the Castlevania games, and that's always a good thing in my book.
So, a limited time demo came out for the game, which lasted until Sunday, and I was able to see how the game plays and some of its mechanics for about 45 minutes. So, let's start with the gameplay. You play as the penitent one, who has his main choice of weapon, a sword, which he can use to slash enemies with. You can perform combos, plunging attacks, charge attacks, and decimate your enemies by many more, which you can unlock by spending the in-game currency that's called Sin. You can get Sin by killing enemies, and you can spend it on shrines, which also act as a checkpoint of sorts. That means when you die, you always respawn there. Think it like the bonfires from Dark Souls games. I have to admit, this game really gave me a hard time while playing, even for 45 minutes. Enemies strike hard and they're relentless. They often will gank you all at the same time, leaving you with little time to think about what are you going to do next. You have to learn their patterns and be patient, or else you're going to end up dying more times than you want to. So the combat results around slashing, rolling and parrying. Parrying is incredibly useful as it enables you to stun your enemies then deal a devastating counterattack. It's difficult to pull off though, as there's a really small window for the parry and you must perform it the exact moment the enemy strikes. If you master it though, you will be able to defeat most enemies with relative ease. If you don't want to parry, you can roll away or jump to dodge attacks. That requires you to be really careful though, because as far as I can tell, there's no tie frames when you roll, so you will be taking damage anyway. I know I did that because I'm really used to games like Dead Cells and Dark Souls, so I was trying to roll into the enemy and ended up taking damage every time. Another thing you can use is sprays. They require some sort of mana to activate and they give you various effects depending on the type you have equipped. The one I had enabled me to increase my attack speed and that was really useful at killing tankier enemies but mostly at fighting bosses. I didn't find another prayer while playing the demo, so I suppose you get more after you beat the first boss. Honestly, I really like the combat. It's fast, it's precise and really rewarding when you get the hang of it. Different enemy types also keep the gameplay loop fresh by forcing you to change your tactics in order to defeat them. Like with phantom-like enemies, you have to be really careful at dodging their homing energy blasts while carefully strike them in the air one hit at a time. Or with an enemy that stands in a ball and stabs you below him with a spear, you would have to avoid getting below him and you must focus hitting him at his head where he can reach you. In the demo, I encountered 3 enemy types and a boss, and they were all really interesting to fight, so I'm excited for what other monstrosities the game will throw at me at the full release. A last thing regarding gameplay is that you can also find items that you can equip that give you various effects, like seeing weaknesses in enemies or seeing through invisible walls. I like that there's enough variety in customization in regard to how you can build your character because it really makes the game really replayable. Now I want to talk about the wall design. It's really good most of the time. You will be climbing ledges, stairs and going through doors, but there's also hidden areas and a lot of shortcuts connecting various areas, making exploration really rewarding if you choose to venture forth. That's how a metroidvania is supposed to be, and I'm really happy they paid attention to these little details. The last thing I wanted to talk about was the boss and the voice acting. Let's start with the voice acting. I was honestly surprised that every line and character I made was voice acted. Most of the times in games like this, there's a limited to non-voice acting, so it's good to see that they decided to go the full way with that. The voice acting was mostly well done, with an exception for a character I made where it was a little bit off at times. We will have to wait and see the rest when the full game releases on September 10th. Now about the boss, well, as I found the trip to the boss really difficult, the boss was not as much. It had some really telegraph moves, but that must be because it's the first boss of the game, so they will have to go easy on you until they start throwing more difficult bosses at you. His design was amazing though, and really grotesque and monstrous, depicting the horrors that there's to come. Overall, I really enjoyed the demo and I'm really excited for the full release. Are you getting Blasphemous? And what platform are you getting it? Tell me in the comments down below. Also, there's another thing I want you to do that's really important, and that's to smash like, smash subscribe once again, and hit the notification bell to be notified about future videos. Until the next time, have a fantastic day.